Hello everybody, my name is Yimage and welcome back to Tales of Zestiria. Now, I realized throughout the 40 episodes, I don't even know what I'm on anymore because it's been a long time since I recorded an episode of this. I think I'm on like 38, 39 or something. I'll know when I edit the video, I should have looked before I started. But it's been a really long time since I actually played because the last time, as you can see, like, right underneath my face cam, a little to the left of my face cam here. So, kind of like down here? Yeah. Yeah, I think that's about right. You might not even be able to see it because it's cropped, so right here. You see the Cerberus on the screen. That is the Cerberus. This is the creature that I tried to face in the last episode, and I was unable to beat. So, I mentioned in my last episode that I would explain a little bit on what happened. So I'm going to do that to the best of my ability because it's actually been a while since I've seen that episode. And I have since deleted that extra footage because, as I mentioned before, I was not proud of it. This thing is a pain in the ass. I went at him for 2 hours straight and he just kept healing. By the time you reach a certain point when his health gets down, all he does is heal. And it really got to me, and as I've mentioned before, I want to make sure that these games are for fun on my channel. And I just was not proud of the way I handled that. And all in all, and that's why that episode was called Relaxing, because I got rid of the stressful moments. And the stress of the new job was still getting to me at the time. I feel as if I've settled in quite nicely at this point. What is this? Since September, I started my new job in September. I feel like I've gotten better in terms of just everything. Everything. I've settled down into the new job, and I'm in a really good place. I'm in a really good place right now. And that's why I want to make sure that these games are for fun. Now, I mentioned also, I would show you the cutscene, which is why I haven't moved, because in my last episode I actually talked over when I was editing the video over the cutscene, so I will show you this in full. But it's basically Sarah saying, darn it, what the fuck is this thing doing here? Because in the last episode we learned that Gramps' domain has been infiltrated, as we see with the damn Cerberus there. And we need to get the Gramps and we need to make sure everybody is safe. Which I have a feeling at this point they're not, because of how tough this thing is. And if this thing is this tough and beating the dragon and all that other fun stuff, it was difficult. But like I said, I spent 2 hours on this guy. So I'm not really looking forward to facing Heldoff. With all that being said, I have trained a bit. I don't know what my levels were the last time that I played the game. I don't know if I ever pause in on screen. But I have been practicing. I have been fighting. I have been, you know, pouring a lot of time into it. I've actually, you guys can see it right here, I've actually put 52 hours into the game, where I think before I only had like 35. So I've probably put in roughly equivalent to a day's work in doing side quests. If we talk to Rose, you have the exclamation points that she does. And I've done a lot of those on top of just some bigger fights. And I feel as if I've trained hard enough and I'm ready. With all this being said, I am not going to make this episode fighting the Cerberus like I did the dragon. I realize I've also been making things hard on myself. I haven't been utilizing things properly, but I'll get to that. I won't ramble on about that. But the next scene, you will see the full fight of Cerberus, maybe. I'll probably cut out some of the drier parts. We'll see. We'll see after I fight him. Obviously, I haven't fought him yet since the last episode. Now, at the beginning of the episode, I almost forgot about this. I mentioned Tales of Zestiria. throughout the entirety of this series, I've called it Tales of Zestria. And I want to apologize for that, because I know I've been mispronouncing it. And I tried to correct myself back in episodes 4 through 6. I did those three episodes all in one sitting myself. So I was doing that, and I just said after that, I was like, oh, I'm pretty sure it's Zestria. I've looked further, and it's Zestiria. And I do apologize for that. Nobody likes their name mispronounced. All right, so I've rambled on long enough. It's been, what, 5 minutes? 6 minutes? So I do apologize. Without further ado, I'm gonna go ahead and try to attempt to fight the Cerberus, and hopefully I'll win, and we'll be able to see the next cutscene. But again, this episode will not be just fighting the Cerberus. So without further ado, let's do the cutscene, and then afterwards, we'll go from there.
A powerful Hellion like this right at Elysia's gate!
Saray!
Yeah! Take this one out!
I don't want to. Because this thing was a pain in the ass. And the other thing is that its weakness is it's that star thing, which I thought was physical. And it's not physical. It's like special arts or something like that. Ow. Ow. And the other thing with this guy, you see that fire and ice breath that he does? That is a guard breaker. I'm gonna do my best not to armatize as best as I can. And I don't want to do my mystic arts either, because I want to be able to armatize when I need to. And... and yeah. Good boy. Ow. Ow! Nope. Great healing circle. Yay. Okay. But yeah, the fire and ice breath are guard breakers, and it hurts tremendously. Ow. Alright. I don't mind armatizing because I can actually have control. He needs to stop guarding. He did a lot of the guarding. It's actually been a really long time, so I haven't quite figured out how to beat him. But the biggest thing that I really need to figure out is how am I going to get to him when he starts healing. I have yet to figure that out. I have watched a couple tutorials, and that's why I wanted to train, because they do so much more damage, and I still haven't quite figured it out other than hit them hard. And that's also one of the reasons why I want to keep my blast gauge as high up as I can. Because... I can do a bunch of mystic arts when we get there. Now, actually, I have to be honest, I'm doing very, very well. But this is also how I started last time. But I want to be able to do mystic arts because that's how they said you beat them. Near the end, you just blast them the fuck with mystic arts because it does so much damage. And it just won't give them the time to regenerate and redo his health. So as you see here, I'm at 10 blast gauge. That is the max between Edna and myself. Excuse me. Pardon my voice. I have been sick. And I'm still... Alright, so he's at 8,000. This is essentially... This is essentially where he starts healing. Once he gets down to about 8,000... Especially as I get him lower from here. So this is where it starts healing. So let's see if we can beat him. Ow! Ow! Ow, whilst I'm paying attention. Alright, well, here's my two. I beat him. I didn't give him a chance!
Right.
That was the best, so, I did this very well, and, oh, I'm so fucking excited. That took me 3 minutes. The time says, right here. Okay. Oh! I'm so happy because I've wanted to finish this game for the longest time, and now I can finally proceed. I have practiced this fight off-screen, and I haven't, but that was the biggest thing. Spamming the Mystic Arts. Oh, that's so cool. Alright, so, let's hurry. So, I'm so excited, guys. It took a lot of training and hours, and I'm glad to see it paid off, and yeah. Ooh, the guards
like
again.
They must have become Hellions, losing themselves and turning on each other.
How could this happen?
It's possible they simply had the same thought that Heldolf also had back in the day. Alicia and Camlann are strategically valuable, right?
Yes.
But the war is practically over already! Which goes to show you how much some morons don't want it to end.
But they're not the only ones responsible for this. There's massive amounts of malevolence pouring out from somewhere.
Probably a sign that the seal my mother forged has been broken.
Yeah.
Gramps, everyone.
Yeah.
Please be safe.
In an episode or two ago, actually it was when I restarted the series before, we learned all the origins and Camlann and stuff like that, that, the seal to Camlann was done by Mikleo's mother, and Mikleo was a human that became a seraph, and I would look back
Something's
looking
wrong.
For a mystical.
Yeah.
Mikleo.
All these bodies of Highland soldiers, but no sign of the people who live here. You don't think everyone...
Please, both of you, don't assume the worst.
Yeah, that's
yeah,
not
they
good.
Had to have gotten away safe and sound.
Well...
You're right. Let's keep up the search.
Well, it looks like... we're going to Gramps's. Why did we go all the way over there? Ow!
Ow!
It's a barrier. It must be something Zenris set up to prevent humans from breaking in.
Gramps! It's me, Saray!
Saray? Saray, you're back!
Yes, thank goodness!
Saray!
Oh, thank goodness. I'm so glad you're all okay.
Where's Gramps?
He told us to wait here. He said that he was going to go drive out the humans.
He went out alone in all this malevolence?
I'm sorry. We should have been there with him.
But yeah. Even if we had, we would only have gotten in his way.
We left him out there to die.
Hey, like Lila keeps saying, reflection good, regrets bad.
There's no way Gramps would fall so easily.
I don't remember his name.
Saray.
I'll go find him. Kime, everybody, stay right here.
Yeah, Kime.
If everyone else was safe, Gramps must be too.
Okay, I have no idea where we go.
Where's the gate of the Dawn of Chaos that Gramps headed towards?
There's only one place in Alicia it could be. In the depths of the Mount Mabinogio ruins.
That's where we first met Alicia. Oh, okay. Ooh, oh, you motherfucker. Simone.
It's her!
We can no longer tell how you will respond. And so, as you can see, we determined this to be the only remaining option available to us.
She has issues
you
she needs
this?
To work with.
Whatever
to work
plots
out.
You hatch, it doesn't matter. I already have my answer.
Do you hate me then? Do you wish to plunge that sword into my breast?
Ow.
Where is Gramps, Simone?
He went to the gate of the Dawn of Chaos to drive away the Earth dwellers flooding in. Though it's far too late at this point to do anything.
Okay, bye. She's such a bitch, but I'm just trying to remember more about her, why she's like this, and I think that might be unclear, and we'll see it later. I hope that makes the most sense, but man, it's just a nasty situation. But I'm just so super excited that I'm finally able to continue the series, because like I said, guys, it's essentially equivalent to a day, but I obviously didn't do that in one sitting. I just, with the new job, I haven't had time, and I'm sorry I keep bringing that up. I do apologize. Oh, whoops. Actually, I know exactly where we need to go. I think. That music, though. But I do apologize for keeping bringing up the new job. But, yeah. So, remember in the very first episode, we couldn't go down here, we couldn't go through here? Well, now we can. I might have seen a little bit also, but okay. All right. Look at all the soldiers.
What is this?
That's not a soldier there.
He was the one who brought in the soldiers.
What a fool he was, right up to the very end.
Oh, that was Bartlow.
Muse!
Well, that's Muse. Yes. Yes, it is.
Lila, quickly! Heal her! Are you alright?
I sense malevolence, but it's not too late if I still have my life to give.
What are you doing? Don't try to move.
Please, dear Seraph, I need to. I must do this. I want to give the world reason to hope, even should it cost me my life.
But why?
Because I believe. I believe that the children raised by Seraph Zenrus will one day grow to become a shepherd and his companion.
So she doesn't
know.
I believe
they will lead us to hope for the future. A bright future where humans and Seraph can live hand in hand.
And that is your answer.
Please, my staff. Thank you.
That's not hard. That's hard. That's hard for Mikleo.
Muse!
Let her go.
Farewell, Muse. I too believe in your wish. And I know it will surely come true.
Thank you.
They didn't even tell her. So, I guess my question,
Mikleo,
is
I'm so sorry.
If she's human, how does she have this power? Although,
I'm sure we'll find Zenrus just up ahead. And our missing Mautellus as well.
Yeah.
Not to mention Catface.
Meow.
Let's get it on.
Yeah.
Well, Sarai has these powers as well.
Let's do this.
Alrighty. Here we go. Here we go. Goodbye.
The prologue to the final act, huh? Lord Heldoff, my master. Can these people truly be stained with the colors you desire? But then, it is my job to see that they are.
Oh, that walk though. Oh, we got Muse's staff. Alright, let's proceed. Purple. Oh, hi.
What? We were just...
Yeah. Must be Simone.
Definitely.
I wonder what she's playing at.
Let's stay on guard.
Yeah. If it's Simone, it's not good. It's not good at all. I want to fight as little as possible because I feel... Oh, whoops, wrong button. Oh, you are not going to give me a chance, are you? Never mind.
Hydra has the ability to regenerate, just like immortals or something.
I hit a wrong button.
So we should try to paralyze them. Lord of Water!
Alright, so Muse has given her life to save everybody. I'm not so sure it was 100% necessary, but Mikleo and Saray were not going to stand in the way of her answer. Just like they wouldn't want anybody standing in the way of their answer. Which, if I recall correctly, is to save Heldoff. Oh, that's a barrier. That's still a barrier. Okay. I have no idea where I'm supposed to be going. I think the bunch of training that I did has made this part a little easier, because these enemies are actually not as bad as I thought they were going to be. But yeah. So anyway, Muse gave her life. Saray and Mikleo did not tell her who they were. Because maybe they're not so sure that they can beat Heldoff. And we'll see. He didn't seem all that tough when we bought him, when we fought him, but then again, we'll do that. I think there's also something, if he did bind with Mautellus, which is obviously the all-powerful Seraph, that became a Hellion back when this whole thing started. But yeah, is that a monolith? Or is that just a thing? I have no idea where I'm supposed to be going. There's no map. So I guess I just wander. I guess. I don't see anything. I don't even see these invisible walls that I keep hitting. Oh, there's something over there. It's another Hellion. Well, might as well fight.
Get ready!
Here it comes! You drop the leg!
So I guess we'll see what happens, but it's pretty sad, you know. I fear the worst for Gramps, just because Heldoff is extremely powerful, and while Gramps is extraordinary himself, I just don't feel like he could take him on his own. And yeah, that's pretty much all I gotta say about that. I just fear Gramps' safety. So, we are definitely near the end of the game, I know that for sure, because obviously we're heading for Camlann, which was the origin village, and we'll go from there. Hi. Do I want to fight you? I want to fight you. These, very weak dogs. These are the upgraded versions.
Of course! I won't let my guard down just because it's fun looking.
I swear, you really are a kid sometimes.
It really is fun looking, though.
Sweet dreams! Sweet dreams! Sweet dreams!
My guess is that Heldolf is in Camlann, hence why there's so much malevolence. I don't know what Simone is doing, other than stalling us and trying to get us to become Hellions. I guess we'll see what happens. Oh, goodbye. Rip. I'm just trying to speculate on what I think is going to happen. I think it's going to be a little bit. And that's the other thing I just thought of. We got to take out Simone first before... before we do anything. Nope, I'm not going this way. There's a bat. Oh, what the hell? Was that us?
So tell me, why are they called vampires?
Well, don't they suck your blood?
Once it bites you, it may never let you go.
Let's make sure that doesn't happen.
Not yet.
That's her name. There's a lot of them, but they don't have a lot of health. Because they're going down relatively easy. But I could have sworn I just saw us. So, is Simone trying to get us to face each other? What the hell?
What the crap?
This is Simone's doing.
Yeah, no kidding.
We don't have any time to lose. Let's blow through this one. You got it!
Oh. Unknown Sarai. Resistances to fire.
Mika! What's going on? I can't deal with this!
Simone, this is pointless. Knock it off!
I don't think she's gonna knock it off. I think facing ourselves is actually going to be one of the toughest fights we're going to do, even more than the Cerberus, but ow.
Stop it! It hurts!
Does it not pain you to attack your comrades?
Of course, it pains our hearts.
But we won't let that stand in our way.
Aim and fire! Let's do it! Binding Vortex! Ready? Go! Shade Zero!
Now, I've decided to use water on this one, because...
Looks like you're running out of ideas, honey pie.
This is
just the beginning.
Oh, that's
sounds like we were right on target.
Shut up!
I'm using the water because of its distance. And actually, these guys aren't as tough as I thought they were gonna be. I should have known that was Simone's doing. I didn't even think about that. I was like, whoa, what the fuck? Well, Big Sarai is dead. But out of all the people, Edna would be the most pain in the ass. What would... I mean, if we go by Pokemon logic, I definitely had the advantage, right? Rock... Ow! Rock beats both fire... water beats both rock and fire, right? Even though I know for a fact that that's not her weakness. Ow! Now, I've also learned that I could heal by just pressing R2, which, again, I've made this game a lot harder on myself than I probably should have. But, yeah. Alright, so, the fakes are gone. Rip.
Lila, it would be tough for a Seraph to withstand this much malevolence without a vessel, wouldn't it?
Huh? Yes. The Seraph would have a difficult time wielding his powers.
Okay.
I thought so.
Ooh. I guess she's running out of ideas for what kind of illusions to make.
Looks like it.
We'll see.
But let's proceed with caution.
Yeah, it would be a very good idea to proceed with caution.
Yeah, the most important thing is to keep calm in these kinds of situations.
So, since we saw the armatization of fire and rock, Edna and Lila, are we gonna see the others as well? Rip. I thought the game froze for a second. Hi. I want you. Ow. Well, I guess we'll see what happens. That's very interesting. Okay, good. Nope. I'm faster! I got a slave in shadow. No! Ah, rip. That was funny. I'm gonna run at you! Monolithic Arm. Oh, that was funny. No, fuck you, Mr. Wolf. Oh, those bats are so fucking annoying. Just the little supersonic that they have. Now, I am extremely happy that I didn't really decide to do this, because I think this is making a world of difference, because as you saw in the Dragon episode, I really struggled to beat him. I'm gonna say who's dazed. I'm gonna get you. But, I don't think I handled that one very well, because he was weak to Earth. Or not Earth, Wind. And I decided to go with Earth, just because I just feel like it's more powerful, but I really should have gone for its weakness. Speaking of dragons, one of the side quests that I did was Edna's brother, and I beat that dragon in one shot. Which I was pretty happy about, which is one of the reasons why I decided it was time. I can't open that one. Shit. I forgot about that. I feel like I'm missing something for that, by the way. I feel like I should be able to open that one by now. But yeah, I fought and defeated Edna's brother in one shot. But I basically did what I'm doing now. I stood my distance and used him. Oh yeah, you might have noticed that I've been using a lot more arts instead of basically just spamming circle, especially for those of you who have played the game. Might have noticed that all I did was hit circle. And that's one of the things that I was hoping that I could fix. Alright, so we found the star. Do I want to go down here? Or is it just more chests? Let's go to the star. Yeah, let's go to the star. Are we going again?
Not yeah. Again?
Alrighty. Alright, so I imagine that we'll face... I imagine we'll face Saray and Rose this time, but with the amortization of water and wind. I don't know who will have what. I imagine Saray will have water and Rose will have wind, but we'll see. We'll see. With what happened with Bezel, even though Rose doesn't have the same connection with Zabid, even though Zabid would want to. That's gonna do it for him. I thought it would anyway. That did. We're not really saying much in our little quirky things at the end here. Nope. Not that way. Hi.
We're here to be
terrified. Hello, bats. I didn't even see them. Who's calling back up? How dare. I still am so happy that all that hard work and, I mean, a little help from YouTube. I wish I could remember the user, but thank you for anybody who's put a Tales of Zestiria tutorial, not necessarily a let's play similar to mine, but more of a walkthrough, because it helped extremely. Were you the one who called for help? Take that. Because it just helped tremendously on trying to figure out how to beat Cerberus. Because, like I said, I even spent some time after last episode trying to beat him. And it just didn't work. And after spending, 2 hours, I beat him in 3 minutes after essentially overtraining. But I don't even think it was really the training that helped me out nearly as much as figuring out more of the mechanics. Oh, I lost my wind step. I can't go that way. Why can't I go that way? Bat. I'm gonna go after the bat. Come on, bat. Hello, bat. Bat. I missed. He missed. Oh, balls. So, I'm pretty sure that we're going to have to face, like I said, Saray and Rose with the other two power-ups, and then maybe Simone after that. Oh, I thought that was me at first. Now, I don't know if I mentioned this off-screen or on-screen, I should say, but for a while there, I had an automatic mystic art, and that was... Oh, what is that called? Like skills or something? I'll look in a second. I'll look after this battle. Obviously, I can't look in the middle of a battle. But one of the things that uses the AP, the thing that we get from looking at the monoliths and stuff, had an automatic mystic art. If I had enough glass gauge, rip. But I had an automatic mystic art, and that was actually hurting me rather than help me. Because of the fact that I wanted to save my blast gauge, and after I learned what I needed to do, I didn't mean to do it that way. Oh, whoops. Oh, and I wanted to look at the other thing. That's okay. But yeah, it was hurting me more than it was helping me. I get the point of it. Are you resistant? Yeah, you're resistant. Nope. I thought I switched. Did they call for help? Where did the second one come from? I'm also trying to think of some other things I want to say. Yeah, I see him. I definitely wasn't expecting to beat him, beat the Cerberus so quickly. That's for sure, especially after the hardship I had in the last episode. But I'm definitely not complaining, that is for damn sure. But like I said, just basically spamming the Mystic Arts did the trick because it does such an enormous amount of damage. He had no chance. But in the meantime, you don't use it until the very end because of the fact that he regenerates. And, I mean, unless you do a walkthrough, you won't know that. But he was a pain in the ass. And I'm so happy As I mentioned, this is, I'm not sure if you guys know, but this is, this has been a really good game for me, and I can't wait to see how it all ends. Which, we're there. Alright, here we go. Oh, I was like, well, what's going on? What is this about?
You don't really want to do this, do you?
That feeling gnawing at you is what brought us to life. Did you know that? Oh, please. We're not so dumb as to fall for that garbage. Simone, are you getting desperate? You go to hell!
These clones are vicious. Yes, it's an unknown special. Ow. Alright, I guess we'll switch. I don't know if it's because I stayed away. Ow. Am I? I was gonna say, am I paralyzed or something? Ow, 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 ow. How do you do that? I gotta get rid of the fake Soray, and then we'll be okay. Even if it's ineffective, I stay away from him. Yeah, this is really ineffective. This is not doing a damn thing. Ow, 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 ow.
Push yourself, Philo! Elixir for take!
For a little bit, it actually wasn't doing any damage. It was actually healing me.
Damn you, Shepard.
You're afraid, aren't you, Simone? Afraid that we'll defeat Heldoff, huh?
Never! You have no chance!
Well, the fixed array is gone, so I've got this now. Well, that was a little that was definitely more difficult, but as I mentioned, if we're going by Pokemon rules, I definitely had the advantage in the last fight. So it's only fair that they get the advantage. I still believe that we're going to be facing Simone here soon. For sure.
Let's go.
But Simone's just gonna throw more of her crap at us.
I bet she will. But it won't be anything we need to worry about.
Probably not. Even her illusions are starting to lose their spectacle.
Yeah.
She can make passable imitations of Rose and Saray, sure. But it's looking like everything else is beyond her reach.
Yeah, if she could scare us with anything she wanted, you'd think there'd be more guts and stuff. Spleens.
Spleens?
Anyway, mm-hmm. Let's keep moving forward.
Right. We don't want to let her stall us here while we talk about how bad she is at her job.
Yeah.
Well, she'll be stopping us here momentarily. I can just see it.
She sure is trying. It's kind of getting annoying.
What's this?
I feel like the effects of her technique are weakening.
Simone. Could it be?
Could it be? Where are we warping? I don't want to warp anywhere. I want to save. Because this is a good stopping point for this episode. Because in the next episode, we will probably fight Simone and enter Camelon. And probably go a little bit more there. So really good, really, really good progress at this point. I'm very happy with the fact that I was finally able to beat the Cerberus. And I'm super, super excited that I got a chance to play it again. I do apologize for the 6-minute ramble, and I apologize for now. If you don't want to listen to me ramble a little bit more, because in the last episode I said at the end of this episode, I'm going to talk to you guys about what my plans are for the rest of this series. Because of how well the game has been for me personally, I wanted to do something somewhat special for the ending, and I think that something special is a live stream. I wanted to do that for some time now, and we'll see as it gets closer to the end. I definitely plan to do, I think, one more episode after this, as I said in my last episode, at least I believe I did, but I plan to do one more regular, quote-unquote regular episode, and then I will live stream from wherever I leave off there to the end of the game, however long it takes me, it's whatever. But I have looked at walkthroughs and tried to get an idea on where I am, like where Cerberus was. I watched him beat Cerberus, but and then I kind of estimated based on their time to figure out where and how I need to go next. Now, I see the star right here. Yeah, I think I was thinking with this warp point that we were going to need to do a dungeon. I know for a fact there's one more dungeon. And who knows, maybe I'll have to look again at specifically where people were, and specifically, because maybe the next episode is the live stream. I don't know for sure, because I don't know where the ending is, and without really spoiling it, I might watch a little bit here and there, but I obviously don't want to spoil the ending of the game, which I really, really want to see. Excuse me. So that is my plan. I will have an official announcement, a separate video, on when I want to live stream. And I think And as I just talk about it more, I just really want to finish the game. So expect that announcement soon, because I think I just convinced myself the next time I play this will be a live stream. I will fight Simone and I will play the game right through to its end. Right here on my channel. I will give you a time and date when that announcement is made, but I am going to live stream the end of Tales of Zestiria. And I'm gonna go from here, because I just don't think there's that much more to the game. I believe this star that I see on the map is Simone. We're gonna be her, and then we'll essentially be in Camlann. There'll be nothing else in our way other than maybe more Hellions. And then I imagine some type of dungeon, as always, and then the final boss of Heldolf and Maltalis. I'm pretty sure that was stated that they combined, or at least that was my understanding. I guess we'll have to see. My next, obviously after this video goes up, I'm gonna figure out a time, probably in the upcoming weekend, honestly. I'll probably live stream, that'll probably be when this live stream is, but I'm super excited. I cannot wait to finish this game out. And now that I've finally beaten Cerberus, there's nothing, I feel there's nothing in my way. Now, obviously, with the live stream, if I do run into problems, it won't be cut. So I guess we shall see. I'm just thinking if that's really what I want to do. I'm pretty sure that's what I want to do. But at the same time, I also know the views of my videos for this series isn't at its highest. Like, say, my Mario Maker or the Laugh Challenges. I don't know how many of my people really want to will actually be watching. Yeah. I'll make a final official decision. I really do want to live stream it, and I might just do it just because it's fun. Just because it's live stream, but we'll see. We'll see. I mean, nobody was really watching the other live streams that I've done, and so I can't be afraid to try that. And like I said, I want to do something special, because obviously this is the longest running series on my channel thus far. There's, like I said, 38, 39 episodes, including this one, I think, and then yeah. I can't really say much about that. It's easily the longest running. Anyway, I have definitely babbled on long enough, so thank you so much for, if you did listen to me babble this long, thank you so much for watching and listening. And look forward to either a really long ending episode next time, or a live stream. So, thank you everybody so much for watching. I hope to see you all again very soon. Until then, take care. Bye. I got the microphone. Shit.